Welcome to Bunny's Designs. This is a live stream for ustream.tv and also for YouTube recorded so people can watch at their leisure. And I'm in the Colin Thompson Fantastic book and I'm zoomed in, so I'm about 4 inches away from the little book, and I'm working with my little book of watercolours. And it's best to work from a paper palette. These are the Derwent Water Colour Pencils. But to work from a paper palette, you have a lot more control. So I'm going to try and show you exactly how I do it. So we have a little pot of water with a baby wipe. Now the baby wipe's going to get very wet, so it's in a dish. So the idea is we dunk and then we just take off and twist to a point. So that is a real damp brush now. And then I'm going to kind of, I want the terracotta for the little pot. So I'm just activating the colour. And then I'm just going to start, now my hands have started to shake. Actually, that wasn't quite wet enough. My hands have started to shake today. They're not, I must have done too much yesterday with them. So I apologise in advance, but that's why when I clicked record, my hand touched it again. So I touched record and then I stopped recording at the same time. So, and I quite like this way of working. Gives you that little bit more control, although I am at not a very good angle, I have to say. But the beauty of this is absolutely nothing to smudge and nothing to spill. So there's no hair dryers to get out. So I'm going to put, because this is Derwent watercolour pencil, these are not like the ink tens, they're not set. When you use the ink tens and they dry, they are fast. Oh, hi Terry, welcome to Bunny's Designs. Who else have I missed? Oh, and I haven't broken chat yet as well. Are you Terry the Third? That's Terry the Third. Oh, I thought I was bad enough with the bunnies, but we've got some Terrys. Some TTs and TTTs. So I'm going to try and get a little bit of a shadow under here. And I'm going to be just have to turn that. So can everybody see that as it in? Because I want to try and really make this a nice painting, because I can't do proper paintings anymore. I'm going to try a little bit with Art in the Abbey, but and you can go to a darker colour, but in fact I might just use the Venetian. It's on here, I've got the terracotta, but because I've got the scale here, I'm using this one, so something about here would be a nice shadow. So again, because you can see all these beautiful colours, and that was probably a little bit too much, but you can play quite nicely with these. And I know it's only a colouring book, but oh, TT says she fell in love with the Kirby Roseanne's A Little Sketchy Book. Yeah, that's fab, isn't it? Well, I love this, my little book, with that. If I'm going somewhere and I can only just get that in my handbag, that's what I take with me. I took that one in my little book bag. I took it to... because I didn't know what to expect, and I thought my daughter might get completely fed up with pushing me around in the wheelchair. And I thought, I've got this, the Sketchy Roseanne story, that's what she's talking about. And again, especially with, this is my practice, I always practice with the first page. And this, that's the ink tense. And that's the lagoon, very deep purpley blue. But if when you're working in this book, you have so much control of your colours that they're intense colours and watercolours. And you can get some very fine things. So TT says it's arrived this morning. I haven't done many. I think I did this one under a microscope, actually. And I think I'll have to do it again under a microscope. Sorry, not a microscope, I do apologize. A magnifying glass. I have a couple of lamps with magnifying glasses. So I think I'll do that under there. Which one was it that I did? And I just love sitting playing with this small book. And again, that's because this works because you've got so much control over your pencil. If you're just scribbling with your pencil and then you use the watercolour to activate it, you don't have this scale and you don't have the control. Even if you scribble on a piece of paper with the pencil. The gentleman that gave me the idea, David Cook, and I'm going to go to Derwent, and I really want Derwent to bring back, not to make you sick, this book, this video, and I bought it for £1. And this is not going to show up, but this is you can splatter with it. You can scrape bits of paint actually onto it, so you look like you've got bits of rock. I mean, it's the most amazing thing. And I think so. I'm going to go to Derwent and ask them if they'll release this because these Derwent watercolor pencils are so understated. They are the best. I do like my professional ones, but if I could only have one set of paints, it would be the Derwent watercolor pencils. They are that good. They are fab. And what he did, in fact, you can see what he did. Look, he scratched on the back of his sketchbook. He scratched his paper palette with the pencils in blocks. Left the pencils at home and went out sketching. And that's what gave me the idea for my little book. But of course, I've put everything in here as well. But you have a lot more control. So yes, I'm glad you got that, Terry. But sorry to make everybody spend pennies because I don't like doing that. But it's a lovely little size, isn't it? And of course, you can still be very creative. You know, even if you can't draw. You know, it makes you feel that you're doing a good job, if that makes sense. If that makes sense. So I'm quite impressed with that little pot. Now I could go further, but again, I've got arthritis. I want to colour something and then go. Move on. It's dry, I can move on. Because I don't want to kind of go back to something. I like to do the best I can and move on. So now we have a leaf. So we've got, I mean, the bronze colour is the most, these, they're almost sandy sepia greens to browns. Now I use the sap green a lot, but if we go to the green section here, there's the juniper green, which I love. The bottle green is for tea roses and things. The mineral green is a lovely one that I use a lot. And then you've got these, but you can see with the scale, you know, where do you want to go? And I don't particularly like that one, but I kind of like this colour here. So I think I wasn't going to do it quite bright, but I think possibly it could be grass green. Or I'm going to probably use May green. I'll use the May one. And again, damping the brush, taking the most of it off with a damp baby wipe. And I've actually found a little pot of hand cream, which was the most amazing cream, and I bought four. And it'll fit around sponge. So I actually could just take the sponge and I could take the little tin with it inside damp, a little bit like the nail varnish things to clean your fingers. Works the same way. The tin's going to keep it dry. And then I've permanently got a little damp brush. That was my, and it's only really diddy. And then because we all drink water now, wherever we go, we've got a bottle of water. So I'm just going to have a bit of a test of this because, again, I don't want to make a boo-boo. Now, I quite like that. It's very pale, but I quite like that. And even though I'm only working with the same pencils, there are 72 colours. So I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure that you can do vivid colours and you can do pale colours. But I like working in the Colin Thompson book as watercolours to make it look like it's a watercolour. And that's quite nice because if I did that in every book, I'd be bored to death. And that's another thing that I found that I've got different ways of working different books. And when I finish this, I'm actually going to put some shadows and scales into this because it's very pale. But I love this way of working. It's therapeutic. Even I cannot spill that. I can knock it, but I can't spill it. And I'm so clumsy these days. And all I'm doing is moving my hand from here to here. I can actually do it without moving my wrist. And for somebody with arthritis, that is so nice. Even colour mixing hurts my hands. And I've been doing some colour mixing, and I thought, why does my hand hurt and my wrist? And then I've realised that I've been colour mixing. So I will be making my colour mixed pot with my professional watercolours, and then I will that will be it. Once those colours are mixed, and I am going to put them in here. There's going to be a palette of just pure professional watercolours that will dry, and then I will reconstitute them the same. And I probably won't bother getting any other colours in here. I think I've got enough. But this is, if you're on a little tray, a cushion tray, this is such a nice, and all I'm doing is just stroking colour. And then just stroking, and all the pressure is in the bendy brush, and that's why it works. It's a combination of having. And again, I can't now scribble these pencils. I cannot scribble them. So, you can get, but you can get a child to scribble a square. Anybody can scribble a square for you. But I'm going to try and get Derwent. I've just gone in the wrong one by accident. And you can tell very slightly. I'm going to ask Derwent to bring these paper palettes out with the colours on, printed neatly with a colour scale. And they can sell them, and you can buy them by the full set of all the Derwent products because they're all water-based. I'm probably going to have a look because I don't like that green. It's not going to be a shadow of that green. I may just have a touch of mineral green. Just to kind of give it a little bit, and this is about as much faffing as we say in Yorkshire, as much faffing about as I want to do, but still have quite a decent page. In fact, I actually think I'm going to go to bottle green in here. I've gone back to mineral green. I just want a touch in there. So if you've got any questions, put them in caps. Yes, I made a video earlier today, which will be released later, and I've got 100 subscribers. Well, I've got more than 100, but when I got to 100, I was so amazed that people want to listen to me waffling. And so I thought I'd do a giveaway as a thank you. And then I thought, I can't really afford anything. And I was racking my brains thinking, what am I going to do? Come out with this piddling couple of pounds, whatever. And then all of a sudden I thought, I'll make one of my books as a giveaway. And that made me feel so much better because it's a unique gift. Nobody else has got one. And I thought that made me feel a bit better that I could actually make one. So I'm doing a series of how to make your own, but as a giveaway. Now you see, I'm messing about too much now with this, really. But having said that, it's therapeutic. I do this for pain relief, and so this is why I wanted to do this. So, if you want to spend 20 minutes on a leaf, spend 20 minutes on a leaf. As Dee Dee says, you are the boss of your colour book. But I do like this just fiddling way of doing things because you don't have to scribble with pencils. Well, I can't even hold a pencil now. It's this. I must have done something too much yesterday. I don't know if you can see just a little bit of variation in there. So again, now that's done, then I want to go somewhere else now. But I'm quite pleased with that. I've got a little bit of shadow, spent a bit of time on it, and now I can move on. And I don't have to go back to it unless I want to. But probably by the time I've gone round everything, I won't want to. Now this book is going to be different. I think I'm going to have to just go to certain spaces and pick things off, I think. I don't think it's a case of moving next to each other. So I'm going to do this is like a brass coal scuttle, I think. But that looks like there's some plant pots here, and there's also a sunflower. So now I know there is a sunflower yellow in the Peerless. Oh, it's a daffodil yellow. But I'm going to stick with the Derwent watercolour pencils in this book. So I shall go to the, oops, sorry, I'll go to the yellows. I'm going to put this down here. I'm just going to pop it on a clean tissue. And what that will do is when I knock my camera, it won't bounce. Right, so let's have a look at the yellows. I think the deep cadmium is going to be nice. And again, there's a scale there, so it goes from very pale to nothing to the most gorgeous yellow. So again, I'm just touching the cad yellow. And just to make sure, I'm just going to touch on the edge there. Now I am using the smallest brush. I got a little bit bigger brush, I think. Oh no, I want the smallest brush. I want the smallest brush because they are quite small. And you can see the yellow on the end there, so that's better. That's better. So actually, I think that'd be quite nice. So I'm going to put a little bit of colour on here and tease the colour out. So it's different from the books. I'm working differently. But that's quite nice. It's just quite nice to be able to. Just very carefully. And again, where am I? Am I in frame there? So I just need to have my hand onto the desk. Because this hand is not playing ball today. And most of the pressure is in the springy. Spring is just really lovely. There's no pressure on my hand at all. And I don't really think I could, and I certainly couldn't get a pencil to this point. And as a tight Yorkshire lass, I mean, I have pencil, but as a tight Yorkshire lass, I couldn't bear to sharpen the pencil every 2 minutes and see all that gorgeous colour disappear. And that's the same with the pencils. The Derwent watercolour pencils have never been sharpened. I must have had them 10 years. Must have had them 10 years. But I've never sharpened them. Because I've got the squares, and I've got the squares, and I can scribble over the top, and I've done that twice. I tell a lie, I haven't done that twice. I've done the odd one or two twice, but most of them. So I really like that pale. Oh, hi Dorothy, welcome back to Bunny's Designs. I'm in the Colin Thompson Water and Colouring book with my little book of colours. And I'm only using the Derwent Water Colour Pencils in this book because I just love the colours, and I love this way of working. It's therapeutic. I'm just stroking the colour in, and then I've kind of decided, well, what I might do, because these are more like, they lend themselves to more reality, shall we say. That's the word I was looking for. I'm just going to look for some kind of colour to give that a little bit of depth. So I've got Naples yellow, and I'm just going to touch in the centre because I want to play a bit in here. And that's just given me a little bit more depth on there. I don't know if that's shown up at all. Didn't want to go any deeper because any nearer. So I can't, is it like a brown, a fawny brown? And again, in the Derwent, there's 72 pencils. There's the most gorgeous browns and fawns and terracottas to play with. Trying to think what colour. I think it's maybe a little bit warm. So I'm going for burnt yellow ochre, and I'm just going to have a touch here. Yes, I think that would be quite nice. And remember with this, you can always go darker, but you can never go lighter. So put a colour in, and if you're not happy with it, you can darken it up a little bit. I know that is extremely pale, but you know, I'm quite enjoying playing with pale colours. I've got the Dr. Martin's Hydrus. I've got the Peerless, and I have the Inktense if I want to go bright and cheerful and things like that. But this book, and again, I love it because it's dry almost instantly. So I'm going back to the terracotta because, of course, I've got three little plant pots here. I'm staying with this little tiny brush because and again, I'm just stroking the colour in, which is, it's really therapeutic. It's just so wonderful to just, you can do this for hours. And I've got very bad hands, but you can do this for hours because all the pressure is in that bendy brush. I couldn't do any other colouring in for hours, definitely not. And if you want it to be a little bit darker, you can just give some shadow. But obviously, this book is already has the shadow. I'm just going to turn it that way purely because I do want. A natural line there. And while I'm with the little mat, oh, I'll do all the terracotta pots first. That was a little bit wet actually. But because I took the colour off here, by the time I got round here, that dampness had gone and it's naturally given. A blend across without me having to do anything. I'm actually quite a long way away from there now, so difficult to see. And then can everybody see that? I mean, these are really tiny. I mean, that's clean finger, just to my fingernails, and they've broken again. But that's my fingernail, so they are quite diddy. Did you want me to zoom in any more? Can everybody see that? I can actually zoom in. I'm not zoomed in. I've just got the camera near. Do you think it'd be... Let's see what happens when I go nearer. We'll try it. We'll try. Oh, says she. I've lost my camera settings. Is that... Do we think that's close enough? Probably. I can't wait for next week. Is it Land of the Giants is coming back? I remember that when I was a little girl. So I thought I might do green wellies. And the beautiful thing about this set, and again, completely dry, is there's a flesh colour, I think, somewhere, with the pinks. There's a flesh pink. So you don't have to do anything with that, apart from activate the colour. I have used a lot of it. I can't remember what I was doing now, but I've used a lot of that. So you can actually see the colour on the end of the paintbrush. Because I'm not going to mess about blending this. This is just going on because it's a bit... It's almost the same width as the paintbrush, so that's going to be extremely tiny. But just taking that colour, the white, stark white, from the page. And again, because you're not using much colour, your water stays clean forever almost. And I thought we'd have green wellies. So we need some green wellies. And of course, I think they can be bottle green. But I'll just test it, because sometimes you do things and you think it's not right. Do we want green wellies? Yeah, we'll give green wellies. So you've got green wellies. It's really tiny, is this book, but you know, you've got to give it the best. And I'm going for a wheelbarrow now. I was going to do a green one, but what else have we got round there? Oh, there's a red poppy here. If I do the red poppy, I don't want that red then, do I? No, we'll have to have a green one. So let's do the poppy. And again, there's a fantastic array of reds. That making me be sick. The madder carmine and the crimson lake are my faves. And again, there's a colour scheme, so it's pinky, that one. The madder rose. There isn't a poppy one, but I think probably the geranium lake. So I'm not sure which colour to use, but I do need to go to a bigger brush, definitely, for this. So all I'm doing with here is I'm just dunking into here and then taking most of that off to a point. Because there's no way I could have a water pot on here. I would be spilling it and dripping and damaging it. So that works quite well for me. But it has taken me years to get this to how I like to do it. So I was going to look at geranium pink. And I think that's going to be too pink. Oh no, it's nearly poppy red. Let me try this one. Deep vermilion. Oh, deep vermilion is the poppy, I think. So I will actually wash the brush out. It's only when I do that you need to wash the brush out. But it is a big brush, this, so there's a lot of water in there. So if I kind of move to the poppy and I'll just... Again, you can see some of the colour on there. Oh, that's a little bit too. So, a damp brush. Oh, I know why I damped it onto a tissue instead of onto a... that's probably a little bit wetter than I'd like, but I wanted to get a bit of a shadow onto that. And then in here, and now this should give me, oh, I can't get the paintbrush in, this should give me a nice natural blend. It's because I've waited too long. You've got to be really quick. You have to be fairly quick. Because if you mess about too much, the damp brush doesn't stay damp for long. And I'm going to have to start at the bottom here in order to get a natural. But that should push the colour out, and then I should get a natural highlight to there. And then this will be this colour, so I can take it further round. Didn't blend perfectly. But it's okay. It's not too bad. And then of course, when you're working, just going to have to bring this over here. When you're working the other way, you now need to be, and that's too big, that brush. Once you do a photocopy page, you normally learn, and that's why I always say to read, just photocopy it and have a play. And you learn which brush is for what size area you want. And because I've got a little touch left on there, I can go back into there, put it that little bit deeper. And then I want a very, very pale highlight, so I'm actually going to steal some from here. Oops. No, I don't. It's not working that. I've decided I want that darker than there. Because it's behind it, so I've decided. And of course, Kirby Roseanne's been very clever. I do apologise. Colin Thompson's been very clever because he's already put a lot of the shadow in for you. The same with the Kirby Roseanne one. So most of the work's actually done for you. So where you see hatching and cross hatching, you know that wants to be dark. So you can build up some quite nice colours. And again, it is what I call faffing about, but it's quite nice. Is everybody okay? Now I'm going to move that because it's getting on my nerves. So I have another baby wipe. I'd like to say whatever happened before baby wipes. So I'm quite pleased with that little poppy. And again, this is a quiet, easy way of working. I'm going to do that little butterfly. There is a lovely blue. And when I was a little girl, I've seen one recently, but until then, I only ever seen one after more than 40 years. I was about 6 or 7. And I opened an old, huge hen house, but it hadn't been used as a hen house for years. It was a shed, but it was, you know, it was more like a little cottage. You could have lived in it. And this beautiful blue butterfly flew out. And I've never, apart from a couple of years ago, it's taken over 40 years to see another one. So I was very impressed. So I was going to do that one, the light blue. So if I move my water pot out of the way, I can show the blues I'm looking at. So I know that on here, is all those blues. And on this one, there's all these blues as well. So I quite like the sky blue. I like the sky blue. So I'm going to do the little blue butterfly. And you can be in your own little world with this. There's just enough concentration for a little bit of pain relief. In actual fact, I like that blue better than I like that blue, but I've done it, so never mind. And that was the blue I was after, but I put a little bit too much in it. But that's a lovely blue, is that? Oh, thank you, Iffy. Yes, it's turned out a lot better. I think it looks better on camera than in real life, but it you've got quite a lot of control working this way. Sorry, I'm trying not to make everybody sick. But it's a lovely way of working. I mean, I'm sitting right in front of my little book. It's a nice angle, and I can just sit for hours and do this. It's a shame I don't do anything. I can't even put the kettle on. I can put my neighbour's kettle on because it's got a better handle. And I've just bought this one, so I can't buy another one. We bought the wrong one, but I can't make a drink. I can't do anything. But I can sit here for hours. I can sit here for hours. But they do take a long time, these books. But again, you know, it's like. If you buy a cheap bottle of Plonk, you just open it, pour it in the glass, and you're away. If you buy an expensive one, and I only buy them if they're on offer, there's something about this white wine should have been £10. There's something about it that you want to savour it. You want to think, well, it's a good wine. And I'm the same with a book. If it's a cheap pound shop one, then I'm like, there's only one exception to that. But if I've got what I call, you know, somebody spent a long time drawing this book, these images, so I want to kind of savour it almost and make the most of it and kind of make it last, unless that's just me. So I need the wheelbarrow, but so we've got the brown, we've got some pixies here. And there's I thought that was a plant pot. It is a plant pot, but that can be a different coloured plant pot. And there's brown, there's a chicken. So we could do a nice brown chicken. Chuck chuck. Unless we have a white chuck, leave him white. Looking for a little brown chicken. I think that's going to be the copper beech. Let's have a look at copper beech and see if we can have a nice little brown chicken. Second, because I'm not quite sure. Oh, that's chicken colour. Chicken colour. So I'm going to have a little brown bird. So he starts off quite dark, and then he'll kind of fluff off a bit. So if anybody's got any questions, pop them in caps and I'll see them so I can put my glasses on. And I've got a natural line there which I didn't really want, but fiddling, it'll disappear. What page am I on? There's the it's the page before the houses in the bathtub, if that makes any sense, because they're not numbered. So there's a bathtub with two trees and tree houses, and there's the patchwork balloon on the next page, the page after. So on here is, it's just like lots of little squares. You found it. I was quite pleased with that little chicken because I made a mistake there. It was a bit brown, but hey ho. Maybe just a touch more. But if I really wanted to, I could just go over the whole chicken because it's a grayscale. And again, no, I did have a drop of water in there, but it's still clear. So I've got this little pot, which is perfect if you're not damaging your brush. Scraping off as much as possible and then twisting to a point. And then I've got this here that's hopefully protecting the page. And I can just double check my colours before I mean, this is being a little bit precise, but again, it's just quite a nice way of working. I think I like the sap green for the. I like the sap green. Did you find it, Dorothy? Oh, do it, excuse me. Did you find it, Dorothy? That looks a little bit darker than it is, but I'm not playing with the colour. But the sap green is quite nice. So we're gonna have, and I should have probably. And because the brush is damp, hopefully I can keep going. Very much like the chameleons, but in the opposite way. The chameleons, blendable pens. I love those. Now I can actually use those. They're the only pens, apart from water, they're the only pens I can use because they're so chunky I can pull the tops off. But I'm going to have to win the lottery if I want any of those. they've just brought, and again, that works in the same way as my book. And that's what gave me the idea of having 6,000 colours. Oh, did you find it? Sorry about that. So to give that kind of a natural kind of. And we'll probably have to have. You normally have wooden handles, don't you? Because that's an old-fashioned traditional one. But there's a lot of brown going on, so we're going to have. No, we're going to have brown handles. So I've had to waste the colour. Shh, don't tell everybody. I've had to waste some colour. And I certainly can't do it with that brush. I hope to do it with this one. And they're normally quite pale, so we'll go for. I quite like this colour. Van Dyke Brown. And again, you couldn't get in there with a pencil, really. And if I'd have used my brain, so again, if I'd have used my brain. Would have blended up. But we don't really need to do that, but that's how the blend goes from dark to nothing. Having said that, I'm quite enjoying just this is a different page just to colour. I don't want the chicken the same colour as the. And I just need to darken that under there quite pleased with that little wheelbarrow. Oh, hi, King. Dorothy, Fee. And Lilth. Welcome to Bunny's Designs. I'm in the Colin Thompson colouring in book, and I'm about halfway through. On the page where there's a basket of eggs in the top middle corner, and there's a falcon orchestral in the bottom right corner. And I decided to zoom in, and I'm using the in this book, in the Colin Thompson Fantastic book, I'm only using Derwent watercolour pencils because I just love the control you have. But I'm using them from a paper palette. So if you've got the pencils, just scribble them down, and you can just scribble the colours that you want and use them as you go along. You don't have to make a little book. So I'm going to do these two little pixies sitting here now. So they're obviously going to have green hats. And there's 72 colours to go from, so I'm not going to get, I don't think I'm going to get bored. Do we want an emerald green? Yes. Emerald green hat would be good. Which is a little bit bright, but. And then they can have emerald green. Everything can match. I'm not sure if I like that colour, but I can always darken it later if I want. And little brown boots. Sorry, I've just realised I'm not. They're very tiny, these creatures. Very tiny. So I wanted to get another page finished. For this, I don't know what colour they have ears, but. And he's hiding behind there, so that doesn't help. So if anybody's got any questions, if you pop them into caps, that'd be fab. Oh, hi Jean, welcome to Bonnie's Designs. I'm working in this Colin Thompson book and quite enjoying doing some quite fine detail, but it's quite enjoyable. I'm not quite sure. Sometimes though you can't actually see what things are, so a bit like the Imagimorphia I was working yesterday with the Kirby Roseanne, you have to kind of I paint what I can see and then I leave what I'm not sure of and then I can go back to it later. And I think this is the, one of the same kind of things. Most of them are okay. It's just when it's in the corner here, sometimes it's a bit difficult to get to. I think that's a lamp, but it's got those red striped lamps that we used to have. So I'm not quite sure what that is. So I'm going to leave that. There's a large plant pot. I'm not sure what colour, but that will show up the little blue butterfly there. There's something going on behind here, which is rather strange. I'm not sure what colour to do with that because. This has got to be brown, just above here. There's, I've got the word for it now. A pine cone. So we'll get the pine cone coloured it, because I think there's going to be a lot of brown down there. I've got an amber colour, I think I quite like that for the pine cone. Let me have a look. Not probably dark enough, but I quite like that. So I'm going to do the pine cone. So are you colouring in the same page, Dorothy? If you've got the same page open. It's not very pine coney colours, but I can always go over it with a darker one if I really want to. I'm using number. Oh dear, I've made a mistake. I flicked into the into the Derwent Ink 10s. Ooh, that's naughty. Never mind. It's a pine cone. This is how I use this book all the time, though. I just flick, see a colour and go, oh, I like that. So I've got to be a bit careful because obviously that's going to be brighter, but that was a mistake. I think that's the pine cone, but I can't quite tell. How strange to do that. But I do normally mix them up. I can see something in that. That's not the pine cone. Oh, I do wish people would. Too complicated. I'm going to have to do that off camera because I can't see very well. But that is definitely something different. And that looks like that could be green. I think it's because it's in it just in the crease. Then I've just seen that face that scared me to death. There's something looking at that's not nice. So we need another green. Let's have a look. There's a beach one, and there's I think the hooker's green. Oh dear, and I've that's perfect. The hooker's green is perfect. With me. I'm going to use these pencils as well because the hooker's green. I've just found another one. This hooker's green and there's vivid green. No, hooker's green. Is the colour of house pipes. So I'm going to have to change my mind and use Derwent Watercolour Pencil and Derwent Ink 10s. So, do you think I can do that? But this is the perfect colour. Perfect colour. And I'm doing the inside first because that's darker. But this is why I love my little book. I flick pages, and I was going to the new one that I make for myself. I'm actually going to put all the colours together. I'm not going to put them in. I don't think I'm going to put them in separate sections. Turn this a little bit because it's rather difficult to get to in there. So there's, I do want that watered down a bit because it's ink tense and I don't want to be too bright. That's too bright in there, but it's hidden. I've just seen a person under there. Again, this is a fascinating book. Apart from Dorothy, has anybody else got this book? have to do this off camera because it's a so-so to get to because it's in the crease of the book. The only thing when you're doing something too complicated, you kind of in your own little world and you forget that you're streaming recording. But I'm not sure where that goes now, it's kind of just there, but it's coloured in, so it's done now. That looks like there's something underneath there as well. I would do wish things were a little bit easier. Oh, that's not a leek. It's a pak choi, and pak choys go from white to green. So we know that pak choi is a very pale green. I think it is, isn't it? It's almost like a fake green is a pak choi. So I'm going to jiggle that round sideways. I just want to get quite a natural colour in there. So, it's a very pale green, is that? But it's what I want. So it was the grass green I used, wasn't it? Yes. I think that's an orchid. And orchids could be any colour. So I may have to Google an orchid. I may have to Google an orchid. Or as my aunt used to say, you've been orchid. You've just been orchid now. It's really a therapeutic way of working, is this? And because you are concentrating a little bit, I'm just going to take that tinge off there. I think pak choi goes almost to white, but I'm just going to have a bit of a tinge of green. So I quite like that area. Oh, was I in frame? So I need to, I'm not sure what that is. That does not look like the underside. Sorry, that's my chair, it's not my spine. Right, if I find my... Gee whiz. I just have to keep fidgeting every 5 seconds. Let me Google an orchid. I'm pretty sure, because at first I thought it was a pansy, but it isn't. I think it's an orchid, that. This is the Colin Thompson Fantastic Colour Book. But I thought I'd kind of get well into the book so you can see that. So if we have a look at images, because there's going to be a lot of dark around here, this section's, there's a lot of wood and I'm not quite sure what's behind there. So I'm not sure if, oh wow, I found that pinky one, that's beautiful, that one. Doesn't really look like that one though. But I think it is an orchid, but it's not. I think that's the old cottage shaking because a lorry's coming. Oh, don't you like old places, honestly? Sorry about that. Um, I still think it's an orchid, but I'm just thinking, what colour is it? I think it's because it's one of the poignant. Oh, the blue's quite nice, though. But I have a little blue butterfly. I think it's just going to have to be pink. Any suggestions? So it's the Colin Thompson Fantastic book. Oh, now that's the traditional colours. They're traditional colours there. But we've got quite a lot of green. Yeah, I think it's going to have to be pinky purple. Wasted enough time, but I'm looking at that. So we have. I'm going to use these two colours, I think. So we've got light violet. I think light violet might go down here. That's a little bit wetter than I normally work, but. Just stroking the colour through. I think probably I could have started with a darker colour and worked backwards. It's probably what I could have done. Sorry, get caught up with the camera. And then pop this one behind, I think. Sorry, the little patter of tiny feet is the little monster. Bless him. If anyone's got any questions, pop them in caps. And I think this would be quite. Don't have to be too precise, you know, it's a colouring book, but it's just quite nice to build up some colour. You can always go darker, you cannot, you just cannot go lighter. So I think I'll leave that as it is, it's done now. There seems to be a tree trunk going up there, but I'm going to do all the tree trunks differently. I normally do the tree trunks with professional watercolour burnt umber. I normally do that because I find it's easier, it's there. There's a lot of it. I'm not going to run out, so I quite like working that way. So all these will be that brown. So we've got a giraffe. There's a little giraffe there. There's a person going upstairs, and there's a bird in the house there. These look like brick red. I'm going to move the water pot out of the way, then I'm not crossing in front of somebody every 5 minutes. Sorry, the puppy's trying to get comfortable. Gee whiz. He takes all the blankets out of his bed and then he puts them back in and then oh, it's just. Oh, I've just found a beetroot. I found a beetroot. So they're purple. But not that purple there. A reddy purple. I think I've got a reddy purple, have I? Can you not get comfortable, Dexter? Hello. The old man's come to see me, haven't you? Old Dexter. Want to see the Dexter? You've seen the terror. This little boy was frightened of his tail. I left my camera up. Dexter, what are you doing? This is Dexter. Dexter. He was frightened of his own tail when we got him. And we've had him 10 years, if not more. Nobody knows how old he is. No. Don't jump up, darling. Off you go. Good boy. Don't jump up. That's a good boy. We've had him 10 years and he didn't know what a ball was. And you used to roll a ball to him and he used to run away. And he's been very, very clingy, aren't you? What do you want? Off you go in there. Go ask Daddy in there. Thank you. I'm looking for a purple for a beetroot, aren't I? I think this is a ready purple. But what you can do is, if it's the wrong... Oh, actually, it's quite nice, that one. If it's the wrong one, I could have changed. And I don't... Actually... Go on, then. No. I don't know why he wants to sit next to me, because there's no blankets. He's just taken about 6 blankets out of his bed. And he's trying to sit on my slippers now. Strange dogs. He's my middle daughter's, Amy's dog, and it's funny because they say you look like your dogs, and she looks like Amy, and then Samantha's long and thin and extremely long. She's about 7 foot tall nearly, and she's 6 foot tall, and she's got legs like the lurcher. It's so funny. So I want some nice green in there now. So I'm looking at the greens. I think mineral green is probably... Yes, I think mineral green. I think if I remember rightly. They have very vivid leaves. But you don't have to do much to this. But Dexter's had a hard life, bless him. And they were a bit too much for me, so I took them back. And the guy said, "Oh, I've had enough of him. I'm just going to shoot him." And I said, "Well, what about Piggles?" Because he used to snap, Dexter, and he didn't mean to, but he used to bite your nose because he was, just so excited to see anybody, he used to jump up and nip and bite your nose. So I got him to stop doing that, but I just had to take them back. They were just too much. And he says, "Oh," he said, "I'll shoot her as well because she came in with him." And so, of course, they had to come back. So we've struggled with them, but they were so badly damaged, bless them. We've struggled with them. And they escape all the time, and such a pest. But they're such loving dogs that to humans, they're loving. They just want to kill every animal we've ever had and other dogs. So it's been a struggle. So I managed to get a little bit of green in there. And I think that's a book. I just found another bit of leaf. And because, of course, all the shading's done for you, you don't really have to do very much. You can just glide colour in there and all the shading's done for you. So it's an easy book to colour. It really is. And that's the tree trunk. And I think that's a book. There's a window there, so I'm just going to just, I think that when I did the Colin Thompson one, originally I used the cadmium yellow, but then I changed to yellow ochre. Sorry, I tell a lie, it's called gold. There we go. So I'm using gold in the windows to show light. We could see, because I've got some, probably won't be any more windows now. Oh, there's a cafe window there. I found some more books. So I just move this carefully. Found a window there. And I can't waste the yellow on there, so I'll pop that into there. I'm going to do this one as well. And that's given a little bit of a glow into there. So I'll do the. I've got to do that plant pot, but I'm not sure what colour to do it. There's the onion. So we started here. There's the brass. Oh, there's a terracotta plant pot here. We'll do that one next. Sorry, I don't want to make everybody sick. There's a plant pot there. Oh, hi, Cass. Hi, Mitts. Welcome to Bunny's Designs. Anybody else I've missed? Oh, good night, Marilyn. Sleep tight. I keep forgetting it's different times of across the planet. So I'm going to put that out of the way so I'm not crossing every 5 minutes. So I'm going to do the pot. I used a big paintbrush for that one. I'm working with a number three rigger for that one. And the terracotta colour. Which is with the browns. A little bit wetter than I normally work, but and I should really be at a different angle, so this side here. But I'm just teasing the colour out. It's if I don't get a natural blend, it's fine. I can go back over it again. It is a bigger area, so you've got to be a little bit careful. You don't get it too damp. It's fine. I'm sorry, my husband's left the door open, bless him. And he's put the washing machine on. Too bad. And of course we've got these gorgeous bunnies. And there's real bunnies and there's toy bunnies in the same place. But again that's dry now, so it's a little bit damp, is that? So I did get a bit of a bobble on it, but hopefully it will go back down. That's because I did use the big the big brush. I'm going to go to a medium-sized brush because I just want to put a little bit of shadow on that. You don't have to go to this much detail, but it's quite a nice book. I did like that nice shadow I had, but never mind the highlight. Never mind, it's gone now. I need to bring a bit more shadow into that one. So it is quite nice to work like this because although you're just colouring in somebody else's work, you can be quite artistic with it, so that's quite nice. And I quite like that natural light on there as well. And these are, normally, most of them are Derwent Watercolour Pencil. So you can actually go back over them if you want to. I want to keep away from there because that is a little bit wet. So let's just have a look what's happening on the other side. It's just a tiny bit there, but you can't see anything. It should dry flat. It'll be fine. So you've got a little brown bun there. Oh, hi, Suzanne. Welcome to Bunny's Designs. I'm working in the Colin Thompson Fantastic book, and I'm on the page before the bathtub. Bathtub. Let me have a look. The page is. It's there's on the page before the patchwork balloon. And I zoomed in because, well, I lowered the camera down because there's lots of kind of little tiny worlds going on. So I wanted to do that. So we've done the plant pot, do that little brown bun down here. And I'm trying to work with just Derwent watercolour pencils that are in my little book, and because I just love the colours. I just love the colours, and I think he could be a little brown bun. That was his ear, but so if anybody's got any questions, pop them in caps, and then I can, it'll make me look up and read. So as I say, I'm just really enjoying, thought that was his foot, but it might not be. Possibly it is. And then there's toy bunnies here, and real bunnies and toy bunnies and different coloured bunnies. So I'm just going to test, because again, it's quite easy to. I actually like that colour for the bunnies. It's quite a nice colour. So I've got three riggers. I've got the number three, the number one, and the 3-0. And I'm quite enjoying playing with those colours. I think that's a bunny colour. So I'm going to do the little bunny down here. So he's done. I think there's a bunny down there. Yes, I have muesli. Oh, hi, welcome to Bunny's Designs. Yeah, I've used the aquatone, but I've had them a long time. I've had them a long time. And they are pure pigment, and of course they would be in my little book of watercolors. I don't actually know where they are. They'll probably have to dig them out somewhere. I can't remember where I've put them now. So I did that little bun. I bit darker. Of course, I think that's the back of him. Yeah, I don't. They're in. Oh, I know where they are. They're in a tin somewhere. Yeah, they're in a tin somewhere. Again, they could go in. They could go in the square because they could go in the square. I might buy some new ones because mine are really old. So when we go to the pencil factory, that's probably something I could buy. Something else. I'm using the Derwent watercolor pencils, but the ones that are in my little book, because you've got control, you can get at least 10 shades, if not more. So you've got full control over how much water you're using. I'm using my little pot so I can dunk the paintbrush rigger, twist it on a damp baby wipe, and then activate the color. Just kind of, and then have a little test to make sure it's the colour that I want. I've actually done a little bit of blending with different. I think this bunny is supposed to be brown, it's supposed to be white, but we've made it brown. All the bunnies are going to be brown. There's another little one in there as well. He could be. I do like this dark bunny here. This really dark coloured bunny. So he can be that as well. And of course, the bunnies don't really need any blending. He did a little bit, but these don't need blending. I'm not sure what colours to do. Oh, I might do the pink bunny. Isn't that a child's pink bunny? That might be pink. Well, this pot is, I have to say, a hospital sample pot. But perfect for water because they don't leak for obvious reasons. And I was terrible when I used to go to the hospital. I used to go twice a year to the kidney specialist since I was 21. And as I very rudely told the doctor as I left her, do you think my kidney's grown back then? Do you think Dr. McCoy's given me a magic pill and my kidney's grown back? Because I don't go anymore and I'm not under a specialist. So there we go. But it makes the books look good. No, I think the bunny's a paler bunny, isn't he? I think the bunny that's child's play bunny, and that's just a little bit too pale. Oh no, we may as well have a we'll have a bright bunny. So and the, but the, what I was going to say is that I always used to forget, because every time they give you a pot and say next time, of course by next time comes about 6 months later. One is I could never find the pot to start with, and the other one is trying to get up at silly o'clock for a train to go to Leeds. The last thing you're going to remember is to use the pot. So there we go, little pink bunny. So I ended up with lots of pots. Quite naughty, really, but hey ho. I do want some kind of pink, and that little foot just around there—that's going to be pink. I can't see what's behind there. Can't be the, oh, it's his paw. Goodness me, put your glasses on, missus. It's his other paw. which one want to be pale pink, really. So if I go in there with the dark, there should be a little bit of pale pink left on there. Just knock off that stark, and so the little bunny's done now. It isn't that small. It's a couple of inches. It's not a bad size, but it's perfect for the riggers. The lid is perfect for the rigger. So that's why I use it, because normal water pots wouldn't be any good because you're dunking into it. So that actually works quite well for it. Not sure what's behind the bunnies. We have another bunny there, so I'm not. I suppose I could do a purple bunny. We've got a pink bunny. We could have a purple bunny, seeing as he's a fake bunny. This is going to be quite dark, so we'll start under here. I could tell you a funny story the first time I went. Never been to hospital really, but only with my mum before. And I didn't have anything for a sample. So I took a milk bottle. And in those days, the glass milk bottles didn't have reusable tops. And nobody told me that they only wanted kind of enough to poke a stick in. So I took a milk bottle full on the bus. Oh my. What a country bumpkin. Oh yes, that's the lid, and that's can actually empty because I'm not using it. That's the pot and that's the lid. But years ago you had tall thin ones like tubes, and I used to use that. So I used to have the stick of Caran d'Ache in my hand, not Caran d'Ache, yeah, near colour twos, and I used to have the pot and I used to dunk into the pot, and then I used to touch the top of the Caran d'Ache near the colour two, and then I used to colour in. And I did that all across Europe when we went on a trip around Europe. And that's what I used to use, but of course nowadays I can't hold the pot, so it's a lot safer for me to put that down, to put that down. I'm working in the Colin Thompson Fantastic. And if I lift that up very carefully. Bear with me 2 seconds, I'll just pop. Something's happened to the computer. I can't do that because I can't. Sorry about that. I can't. The controls for the cameras has disappeared, and when I pressed save the recording earlier, it froze on me and it wanted to kick me out. So what I could do though is show. Don't make you sick. It's the Colin Thompson Colouring In book, and it's the guy that did all the books. This is the first page, and I just loved, and I bent it back, but this is, I love these colours, so I decided to just use Derwent watercolours in there. because they lent themselves to such really nice watercolour effects. So I decided to do that. And of course, on this page is there's chickens, and I think this is all the countryside because there's lots of flowers and bunnies and the wind in the willows. To serve them all my dahlias. Sorry, the wind in the willows. Oh, it does say willows. He changes the titles of the books. He's very clever. But there seems to be all plants and pots and things going on, and I know what colour that my auntie my nana had that pot plant teapot. And a grass cutter, we had one of those. So a lot of his little worlds are from his childhood. So I guess he's as old as me. But I'm trying to work through it. The thing with the hydras is though, oops, I've had an avalanche. You see, I've just spilt my pot of water and nothing much has happened. So that's another reason why it's brilliant for me. But you can throw it in the bottom of your handbag with water in it and it's not going to leak for obvious reasons. Now I need some more water now. Saying, I'll have a quick slurp. So I started with the plant pot and the little plant, something easy to start with. Sorry. Oh, thank you. It's a grayscale. It's really easy just to kind of gently go over with color, and it's a really nice way of working. I've got my little book and I just flick for colors. But be careful, I always do a photocopy first if you're using different colours because these are very, very, very vibrant. And the best way of working with these is from dry. Can't do this with. Is let them dry, and those are the drops. Because you have a lot more control than you do from a wet palette. As I found out when I did the aviary, and I was so disappointed. I was so disappointed I bought the book again because I was cross with myself. Because if you work from wet, you can't get this lovely gradient. So you start from dark and again, long rigger, and you go to almost nothing. And you get the most beautiful gradients. And when I did the head, you start, and again, it's like the opposite to the chameleon pens. You've got colour at the end and a damp brush. So you start with the colour, and the more you go across, the paler and paler, and it's a natural progression. But when you're working from wet, you don't have that. So I didn't like this. I envisaged that it would start dark and get paler and paler and paler to nothing, and it didn't. So I was a bit cross with myself. But I really love the gradient way. It's a natural blend without having to change your paintbrush or change anything about it. You just keep going, and I really like that. So those are the colours for the hydras, but it's the same paper. You know, you've just got to be a little bit aware of working damp rather than wet, and you can use any paper for that. If you've got any questions, pop. them in. Yes, I put them in here and I work from here. There is a video, the video that I made earlier, I put them in drops and I was making these, I mean, they go forever. And that's the colours that I made. I mixed two together to make a teal. And those are just the drops. And then you've got so much more control. And you can still do your colour mixing. My advice is to buy... I bought the first set. And if I'd have known, I'd have just bought six and made my own colours. But that's me. And I've put them into my giveaway when it's finished. And they do smudge across. But as long as this is all pure colour, as long as this doesn't move about too much, and I've labelled them. And there's 18, but you've got to keep these perfectly flat if it's on plastic, because it'll run, because it's just like water. And so the phthalo blue and the phthalo green run together, so that's probably giving me phthalo turquoise. So they're in the little book as well. And I made this morning in my first video, my first stream. So I've cut my pans and given a couple of millimetres. And so this is going in the front of the book, so whoever gets the book can make any colour they want. And they've got the two reds. I'm going to buy a lemon yellow because it kind of went a bit ugh. So I decided I would, it's dried out quite nicely actually, so I could have maybe cut some off there. I'm going to buy a new one and then I can cut 2 millimetres off and put that into the little thing. And so I'm going to put the Derwents in there as well. Because as I say, I wanted to do a giveaway to say thank you for getting to 100 subscribers. I was so in awe that anybody wants to listen to me waffle. And I was thinking, well, I haven't got anything decent and I can't afford to buy anything decent. And then I had the idea that I could make this for practically nothing and fill it with all my own stash. And somebody's got one of my little books. So I've got the 42 Peerless in there, the full set. I'm gonna ask my daughter to scratch the 24 Graphy Tint. There'll be the 72 Inktense pencils and the 72 Derwent pencils, watercolors and Inktense. And then this will go in the front as well. And I'll probably put the Gansai Tambi watercolours in there as well. So that's for my giveaway. When it's finished. So I'm doing a video of how to make your own. And then there'll be a giveaway. So that made me feel a little bit better. Because I could actually give something to somebody that nobody else has got. I think that's a good idea. Well, I'm going to Derwent to see if they can do this. And if Derwent don't, then myself, my daughter last night, she's going to be scribbling squares of pencils onto sheets of paper until she's 21. But I do love my little book. And the Gansai Tambi watercolours, there's a gold in there as well. They're absolutely fab, little fat puddles of colour. And again, you've got a lot more control over the pencils. So I always advise people, scribble some squares of colour and then use them. So I'm going to Derwent next week. Oh, hi Topaz, Terry, anybody else I've missed? Cara, welcome to Bunny's Designs. I'm colouring in, but I'm just using the 72 Derwent watercolour pencils, but I'm using them from my little book, because you have at least 10 different shades. So it's made 72 into 710 colours, which is ample for one colour book. So I'm having quite a lot of fun trying to be a little bit more realistic as well. So it's even though it's a grayscale, it's quite nice. So we've just done the bunnies. And there's a little bunny there hiding. So there's some peas. I think they're peas, or are they beans? They look probably more like beans. And they're sprouts, definitely, because he obviously grew up with the parents with allotments, because everybody kept strung up the things to eat and things. And there's an Hawaiian shirt there, and a cabbage white. We all hated the cabbage whites. My daddy used to try and kill them, and I was, no, it's a butterfly. But of course, if you don't get rid of them, they do that. But I think we managed to catch them and put them outside. I think that's a robin. There, there's all sorts going on. So this is all a gardening one. I'm pretty sure it's all gardening. And I'm working with the three riggers that I'm using: number three, a number one, and a number 30. Because I can work all day with this, because all the pressure is in the bendy brush at the end, and you just about got enough dampness in the brush so you don't damage your pen, your brush, you don't damage the paper as well, because I do like to keep them quite flat. So I do have a little brass, I think they were coal scuttles and coal scuttles and log baskets, weren't they? But that looks like brass to me, so I've got a choice. I can try and do, I think this gold colour here is quite nice. I mean, there's ample colours. I don't really need any other colours, but by mistake, I used a couple of ink tens earlier, because I'm so used to just going through and flicking to colours that I want rather than looking at what they actually are. So I should have tested that, but I quite like that one. And of course, under here, I can go back in and be a little bit more. It can be paler, and that can be pale. And the top can be just. I'll put that there, and I'm not crossing everybody every 5 minutes. So I think it was Dorothy. Dorothy, were you colouring in the book at the same time? It is a nice book, this, I have to say. It's a lovely way of working, and it's just quite therapeutic, and you don't really have to spill anything. And I just really like working like this. It's just a damp brush, and all I'm doing, which is why this pot's perfect, is dunking the brush. A couple of Get as much water as you can of, and then just twisting on a wet baby towel, baby wet wipe, and that gives you just enough to get some colour on the end, and have a damp brush to work the colour around. And if you stick quite damp, it's fairly dry, and it doesn't buckle your pages. And then I quite like that sunflower. So what I'm going to do is just, oops, sorry, just put that like that, and then it can't bounce. And I just need a touch of a fawn colour. Think that might be fine. I just want to give that a little bit more. Probably the third one would be good. But I could do this all day. This is quite a nice way of working. And there isn't a lot of pressure on your hands. So thanks for joining me, everybody. This is a live stream for ustream.tv and also recorded for YouTube. Just want to have a little tiny bit of a definition of that sunflower, because I quite like a sunflower. So it does need to have a little bit of definition, really. And you get quite carried away because you're in your own little world. Or you're in Colin Thompson's little world. Oh, thanks, Suzanne. It's a nice way of working. I did think that buckled a little bit because there were big areas and I used the bigger brush. Whereas normally I work a lot drier than that. So you've got to be a little bit careful if you want to keep it flat. But you can get some really nice watercolour effects. Not sure I'll keep that because I can't see the little butterfly. But sorry, the flower. I could possibly just darken that down a little bit, maybe. And this is watercolour. This is watercolour pencil, so it's not set like the ink tends. So it's very pale, but you can just about see it. And I'm just walking around, just puddling around, looking for things that look familiar, really. Again, bit of a wimp. I look for things that are familiar, and then colour those in. So we've got some water lilies here. I think there's three sections with the water lilies. So, oops, I need to spill the water then. A quick slurp. So we've got the water lilies. So we've got a deep green. So I think sap green could be quite nice. And again, if I'm not quite sure, I've got my trusty little bit of photocopy paper. Quite like that. And so I can kind of go in now. And all you're doing is just stroking colour into there. So it's so much nicer than scratching with a pencil. And the problem is I just couldn't do that anymore anyway. So it's definitely a no-no for me. So all this springy, all that, instead of it being in my hand, it's just being, and I'm just literally stroking the paintbrush across. So there's no pressure on my hand at all. And that's the only way I can work. But I can work for hours, and it's so nice to be able to do something. It's just so lovely to do something. And because, again, these are scaled, grayscaled, you don't have to do any blending at all, really. You just stroke that colour in. And the worst thing you can do is spill a tablespoon of water. Now when I water when I watercolour a napkin, I use a teaspoon of water. Again, you just got to be a little bit careful, but there's nothing on there at all. So now I need some, I think the probably, oh, we could have a yellow water lily. I have a yellow water lily. Oops, I've done it again. But I keep just flicking through for colours. I think possibly a deep chrome would be nice. Perhaps I should have done that pink actually. But never mind, it's done now. And then let's change to the tiny 3-0 and we'll put a stem. Anybody's got any questions, pop them in caps. Oh, Suzanne says she's got some regular riggers and she's got a number one. Yeah, number one's quite good. I mean, it's still got quite a nice point on it. Oops. So if you've only got a number one, that's fine. Just use that one. I think the trick is the damp brush. So you can do it, you can watercolour this way without a rigger. But it's the damp brush. Again, you see you've touched it, absolutely nothing. Although I do have a lamp literally 4 inches away. So it's quite warm in here. Quite warm just under this section. I'm going to do this little, the only thing I've got to remember is where the water pot is, because I've got an awful habit of dropping things. So I always think that this is quite boring watching somebody, especially this small. Oh, we've got a chestnut there, look. Wow. That's a good colour, isn't it? Chestnut green, I think. Just have to think which green it is. I think it's this one. So we're going for green, May green number 48. Where's the concock on? There he is. And just stroke behind those. And I think this is the finest one. I don't know why I picked this one, but yeah. So you want the watercolour, whatever it is, to be as near as damn it dry. There's kind of like wet and dry, and you want to be there, so you want to be able to put it down if it's dry, and then you don't buckle your pages. And it's a very fine line between damp and dry, because if it isn't damp, when you try to move your brush, your brush will jitter and it will go over the line. So it's, but if you do a photocopy first, By the time you fill the full page, you'll be an expert and you'll know how damp to do it. You'll have a good idea of all the colours. You've had a good play with bright colours and dark colours and all sorts. And you'd have ironed out all the techniques with these, because you'd rather spill this and make a mess on your photocopy than you would in your book, or I would. So again, that's another good thing, is to do it on a photocopy first. And then you learn which paintbrush you like best. You might not like working with this paintbrush. You might like working with a fine paintbrush that doesn't hold a lot of water and work a little bit damper. There's all sorts of variations. There might be a paintbrush that's got a big chunky handle that you find easier. So you want to work with that one. I think this is on colour inside here, but yeah, the cream inside, aren't they? Made a mistake on that, but never mind. I think the kind of fawn inside. So there's all sorts of different reasons to do there's all sorts of reasons to do a photocopy first. I mean, if you're in town and you don't have a photocopier, if you're in town and you buy the book, just go to a local store and get it photocopied. And you only need one. So it's going to be 10p or 25p or something. And then it's done. That's looking a little bit too bright, that, but I think it's right. Oh, have I missed a question, Suzanne? Sorry. Oh, do you have an opinion on those? So I do apologise. I've bought these from a model show. And they are kind of not real. Again, there's something nice working with real paintbrushes. You know, oh, sorry, real paintbrushes. Real squirrel or hog hair or horse hair or whatever. It's all personal preference and price. I'm a tight Yorkshire lass. In that box of goodies that I got, there are two of these, but I'm too frightened to use them at the moment. I probably will when I go to the when I do art in the Abbey. I'm going to do art in the Abbey, and it will be a whole day. So there will be a day of drawing, live, and then there will be sorry, a couple of hours drawing to get a really good image, and I will be using my dividers, my scale dividers. Oops, I can get them out for measuring. So measure at one side, look through what you want to measure. So there, if I'm drawing this again, I will do that. And then the scale is what I'm drawing, so I know that mine's got to be between these two points. And you measure everything. And when you get the accurate drawing, then I'm going to do watercolours, a professional acrylics, and water-based oils. And there, oops, they're the Winsor & Newton artisan, and that's the thinner. And hoping to do that quite soon, but to practice, because I haven't used oils for a few years, I'm going to do the Harry Potter colouring books, and I'm going to make my own gesso, and then I'm going to oil paint and acrylic in those. Yeah, the imitation ones are a couple of pounds. My fave at the moment, I have to say, are oops, and I love these, are the Pro Art ones. And I think it doesn't matter what size you get, the Series 55 are really good. It doesn't call them a rigger. There's a miniature there. I don't know what they're made. The Art Master Pearl Series 55 is quite good. So That might be a bit blurred. But okay, that's got some really good springy action on it. I do like the Art Master Pearl 55 number 10. Sorry, 10-0. I did buy these at a model railway show, Pro Art. There's a 3, a 6, and a 5. And I'll probably use those for the acrylics and oils. Again, they're all fake. None of them are real. None of them are real. I don't. I think they're good enough now. I think paintbrushes are now good enough to be fake, if that makes sense. It's very much like I'm reading this. And the other thing I'll be doing is the color mixing. So Art in the Abbey will all be professional watercolors. So I've got this book. Oops, without making anybody sick, and it's all about colors and the actual chemist colors and what they're called. But again, we've got some really good, nice fake colors now. Most of them are fake. They're not from real pigments because they're very expensive and they're also poisonous, most of them. So things have come along a long way, but I'm going to be mixing colors a traditional way, like the old masters. So I'll be doing professional watercolors, professional acrylics, and professional oil paint alongs. And they've provisionally given me permission to do it. I have permission to do it, but it's the ins and outs of doing a live show. But technically, I will be there once a week doing a live show in Selby Abbey. And that's going to be, as I say, getting the drawing correct first, measuring. And I was going to just show the actual image of the Abbey, but I think people want to see what I'm doing and how many mistakes I make. So I will be setting up. I'll be setting up so you can see my easel, and then behind the easel you can see the image so you can paint and draw it yourself. Does that make sense? Yes, this book here is hundreds of pounds, but you can download it free if it's an iBook or an EPUB. So I think it's Amazon Books. I'm pretty sure it is, and it has the original drawings in it, where of course this one doesn't. Bear me 2 seconds. Let's see if I can find the phone. Because I want to get back into doing professional stuff again, but that's once a week. And because I'm not well, I have to do this. And I do this for pain relief. I do this so I don't take any painkillers, although you have to forgive me today, I have to take some painkillers. But that's why I sit and stream for hours, because while I'm concentrating on this, and you do have to concentrate, then it takes the pain away a little bit. Not always and not forever, but most of the time. And I put my little phone somewhere. Oh, Carol says I have 8 Isabi brushes. Is that the lady in England that actually makes her own? Is that Isabel? And she actually makes her own. That's Isabey. Is that the lady that she makes her own brushes? She makes them out of hog hair as well, didn't she? But I will be using my proper. Oh, sorry, that's one. Yes, duh. This was in a box for £28, and I think this brush itself is 12. Sorry, I'm not quite with it today. Sorry. Again, I apologise. The painkillers stop the brain functioning. Yes, these are beautiful, fluffy, fluffy, fluffy. But I will be doing a pre-video, a pre-program the week before, so that everybody can prepare their pages, prepare prepare their canvases and get everything ready. And colour mix as well. If you want to colour mix ready, that's fine. Oh dear, excuse my stomach. I've just drunk a pint of water. So that's my goal for that probably will be the new year, I think. We'll see how the weather goes and how everything goes. Yes, I've just realised it did say France on it. But there is a lady in England that makes her own, and I can't think of her name. And I thought it was Isabel. And she makes her own brushes. She's making them, I think, about 10 years. Yes, of course, the professional ones, they are lovely. It's like professional watercolours and watercolours. But I don't want everybody to go out and buy really expensive things, because one is we can't all afford to do that, and art should be free, and are as free as possible. And I'd love to set up something that if somebody's got 72 pencils, I mean, they do not damage the pencil. Oh, I just can't get to. Oops. Oh, I've dropped it now. I don't even last. I've never sharpened any of these. And this is the ink tens. And I've done two squares of this. So, you can do quite a few squares. And you're only using one pencil for each square. So you could get somebody that's got the 72 ink tens, but they don't have the 72 Derwent watercolours. And you can say to them, well, actually, I'll make squares for you if you make me 72 squares of the other colours for me, and swap. And that means that two people have got two sets for nothing. Oh, well, not for nothing, because there's a bit of postage, but again, there's six pages, I think. The six pages. There's not much, it's a few millimetres, quarter of an inch. The same with the peerless. One set of peerless, you can get at least five or six decent squares out of them. And then everybody can play and got them. And then if you get them and you might not like them, you think, I've just spent all that money and I don't like them. Whereas if people did samples, it would be a lot better. But of course, we can use samples. We can get a lot of colour out of samples. And as I say, I'm hoping that Derwent will bring out some kind of a book where you can put in pages that you buy and all the colours are on there. And then, if you love them, you can buy the full set. I'm sure they do, yes. I mean, obviously, what you do with them is you dunk in and twist. And you should get. Oh, sorry, it should get quite a. They twist to a point. So you could do like the Japanese writing with them. But they are beautiful. As I say, I think these are about £12, but they were in a box. I think there were three watercolour ones in a box. And again, because this is full of water, this is how it works. You've got the tiniest amount of colour in there. And you move the colour around with the water in the brush. That's professional. That's watercolouring. Sorry, that's traditional way of using watercolours. I will get it out. But you have to get your paper. You have to wet the paper. You have to put it down on a board. You have to stick it down around the edges. But having said that, there's a little man here who is brilliant. Again, a cheapy girl. He brought line and wash out, and also this is a double video. So he shows you how to do sketches, but he also does the colour mixing. He does fantastic colour mixing, and he also does how to prepare. It's stuck down is that paper, and he shows you how to put it on a board as well. So if you can get hold of this, it's fab. And I've just realised the time, because I think do you, I'll just stop this video because I've been waffling about that, but that's a fun thing. So thank you for watching the Colin Thompson Colouring In with Derwent.